Hello, everyone. I'm Cory Newton-Smith, and I'm excited to be here today with my colleague, Nate Tennant. We're going to talk about content AI and automations. So let's dive right in. With over 2 billion files added daily, SharePoint content is a goldmine of knowledge. The massive scale of the SharePoint data estate empowers you to build automations with agents, while grounding Copilot as a business knowledge expert. The opportunity is in aligning both your AI and content strategies to supercharge your success. And SharePoint Content AI is here to help. Effortlessly enrich your enterprise content. Today, we're here to talk about how enrichments can fuel important business automations. However, enrichments also improve Copilot and agent understanding, fueling productivity across your organization. Features like OCR and document translation can help improve AI understanding, while autofill columns are our heroes of enrichment, using LLMs to extract and generate structured metadata. What would take hours to do manually can be automated in a matter of minutes. Autofill is a library column setting that includes an LLM prompt. You can manually target existing files, and once set up, an autofill column will automatically target new and modified files too. Let's see it in action. Here I am in the Green Energy product specification catalog. You'll notice that each document has a convenient product summary. This is actually an autofill column. Let's check it out. Here you can see that the product summary column has autofill turned on, and you can see that there's a prompt attached to it. The prompt is very simple. It says, extract a brief two-sentence summary of the product specification. This is the ease of autofill in action. Now let's set up a column of our own. I'm going to go over here and create a new column. And it's going to be a text column, and it's going to extract the product name from each of these documents. So I'm going to name it product name, and then I'm going to go here to click setup. In the setup, you can see that autofill is suggesting a prompt for me. I'm going to select this prompt, which is very simply written. Please extract the product name from the document, ensure the name is capitalized properly, and if the product name is not found, return not found. I can test it against a document in my document library to make sure that it's working correctly. Here you can see that it's extracted the product name correctly. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. Going to save my new column. And then I'm going to select all of the documents in my library and run autofill against it. This will populate the product name column for me automatically. Now that I've configured this autofill column, any new or modified documents will also be processed by the same prompt, keeping my document metadata up to date. While that's running, I'd like to show you another really cool content AI feature right here in this library. It's called document translation. Right here, we're connected to the latest translation services. I can easily translate one of these PDFs in up to 10 languages. There are 5 easy-to-use languages here, but I can also search for additional languages like Romanian, and I can even provide a glossary if I have specific terms I don't want translated or I want translated in a particular way. Translated copies are stored conveniently here in the same document library and maintain the same access control settings. Now, let's refresh our document library so that we can see all the great metadata that autofill and translate is populated. So here we are in the document library. I've updated my view so that you can see autofill has filled out all of the product names from my documents. Now I'm going to hand it over to my colleague, Nate, who's going to show you how to take advantage of all of this great metadata in business automations.
Awesome. Thank you, Cory. It's really great to be here with you today. My name is Nate Tennant, and I am a product manager in our OneDrive and SharePoint team. And today, we're going to talk about automation capabilities that we can extend even further with our document library. Before we talk about automation in SharePoint, we have to mention the great partnership we have with Power Platform, giving you native integrations, as well as the ability and the full ecosystem to go and extend your solutions even further. Let's jump back into the demo with our document library. I'm back in our product catalog, and you can see the rich metadata powered by autofill for both the product name and the product summary. You'll also notice that I have a special approval status column, which is our new lightweight integration with both the Teams approvals app and the underlying Power Platform approval service. Without ever leaving SharePoint, I can go in, select the item that I want to send off for approval, click the column, and go ahead and add in CJ. And I'll add Cory as well, and I can decide if I want them both to approve, or in this case, if one is fine, and I'm going to give them a quick note to say, please approve, and then I'll go ahead and click submit on that request. Now you're going to see that approval request get created, update the pill here in real time. Let's take a look at another request that's already been submitted for me to go and approve. I can get the approval details right here in SharePoint by clicking on the pill, and I can see that Cory sent me a request for the A300 series. Now, let's say I'm someone who spends my time in Teams, and instead of in SharePoint, I actually want to go over to the Approvals app. You'll see that same familiar approvals experience with a link back to the source document in SharePoint and the request details that Cory submitted in SharePoint. I'm going to say this one looks good and go ahead and approve right from Teams. Coming back to SharePoint, we can see if we open up the details here, the same document that was approved within Teams now shows up here in SharePoint. Now, there's another piece of automation that you're not seeing here directly within the library, but the team that I work with for this product catalog really likes to collaborate within Teams. From SharePoint, we have a flow running in the background so that anytime a product catalog spec is updated to say high priority, it posts this nice looking card in Teams. That way, I can chat and engage my colleagues where they like to work. You'll also notice that same autofill summary is included in the adaptive card, along with a link back to SharePoint and some custom actions I've built to say, go book a meeting or contact the product catalog owner. This is a great way for me able to bring that context and rich metadata of SharePoint directly into Teams. Let's take a look at what that flow looks like under the covers. You'll see here every time that a file is created or modified from the Green Energy site in the product catalog document library, I have a condition to go and check whether that category value is high priority. If the condition is true, I have an adaptive card ready to go in Teams that pulls dynamic values for the file name and the autofill summary, again, populating here right in the card in Teams, making that a really nice experience to start to extend the rich metadata we have in SharePoint all the way back into Teams, bringing data and context right to where my users like to collaborate. These are just a few of the ways that you can bring the rich building blocks and features within SharePoint to start to string together your workflows and business process solutions. We're really excited to continue to build and bring more native capabilities, but also give you that extensibility and rich ecosystem of Power Platform. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope you learned a lot and are excited to go ahead and bring these different building blocks to your solutions, configure both content AI and automations to help your organization.
To learn more about content AI and automation, don't forget to check out the links below. Thanks for watching.